glide into position for the opening draw. The quest for Lord Stanley's bump continues right here tonight, and we are underway. Winds up, lets it go. Another stop by the goaltender. Again, the denial by the goaltender. Hutton's been brought down, and we're going to get a penalty here. Here's a chance. And the puck stopper tags his man to get the extra attacker on the ice. And here comes the judgment from the official, tripping the call on the play.
I don't necessarily think he's trying to trip him here, James, but he gets a stick into his feet. Down he goes.
From the point, they take control of it. Slides the puck near the front of the net. And there's the save.
Erickson can maybe breathe a sigh of relief. He's in his first game of the playoff, and he gets tested. Makes a good save there.
Puck is dropped, and we are back underway. From the point, looks to make something happen. There's the whistle stopping play. Penalty coming up here. Smith Pelly's off to the box. 2 minutes for tripping.
Once he puts up his little token argument here, he's going to circle around a bit and try and regroup here as he goes to the penalty box.
Were you a handler?
Always. You never think it's the right call.
Marlowe's trying to gain a step. He's in! What a stop on the breakaway! Trying to clear from the defensive zone. And they get it down.
Yeah, good communication. They talk to each other. They're in the right spot. They just clear it down the ice.
Now a quick pass to Aver. Smart defensive play there. Ahead of steam now towards the front. He scores! That's a short-handed marker.
James, they took advantage of one little crease, and they were able to race up the ice, get themselves a short-handed marker here.
Lots of time left in this period. We've got a 1-0 hockey game thus far. Oh, what a stop! The Aces gain possession in their own end.
Well, the man advantage unit might welcome being back at even strength after giving up a shorthanded goal in that power play.
And the officials are calling a delayed penalty here. It looks like a trip. And let's see what the call is. Del Sotto's been nabbed for tripping. Played with fire. He got burned, Ray.
He's digging around for the pocket. Sometimes you just get caught. This time the player goes down and he's got to go to the box.
He scores!
The power play comes through. They move the puck nicely, and they're able to capitalize on the extra man.
Agostino's won the draw here in the open ice. Here's a blast! Answers the call with a big save! Up the neutral zone now. Look out, a 2-on-1! Simple stop by Erickson. Peoria's got the puck along the boards. Play whistle dead because of an offside. Still a lot of time left in the period as we approach the midway mark. The next goal could be a big one as we are tied. Peoria's ready to go on the attack. Keeps hold of the puck. Jabs the puck away. Carries it in. They've got... Here he is, trying to get loose! There's the go-ahead goal, and we have a new game!
Taking the lead now, you control it. You push the pace, you push the other guys back on their heels.
Peoria's got the one goal lead here in the opening frame.
Better to be ahead than behind, and the coaches are telling them that they want more aggression. They want them to play more in the offensive zone.
Here's an odd man rush. Denies him. He got all of it. And off the save, that one's redirected out of play. The Aces have had way more chances offensively, and as a result, they're leading in this one. That's blocked. Stopped by the goaltender.
Sharp reaction save. Oh, look at that. Here we go. We got a penalty coming up right here.
Officials blowing the play dead. We've got a penalty on the way here. Sin bin down for tripping.
I always hated taking tripping penalties. It always felt like there was something I could have done better than that.
Taken by Hutton. Quick feed to Thornton. They've got numbers. Heads deep inside the offensive zone. And he's taken down, the official's arm signaling for a penalty. Pretty cut and dry with a tripping call here.
Yeah, but James, every player argues the tripping call because you feel like your stick was in the right place and the other guy stepped on it. Never your fault.
Yeah, it looked like there was some late moment lobbying there and it didn't work.
It doesn't work.
No, none.
Sends it over, and he gets a paddle on that one. Oh, that's a smart heads up
play as he breaks it up with the poke. On target. Puck picked up by Thornton. And now he tries to get it across. And that's another power play marker.
The power play coach is going to be pumped here. They had done some extra work on the power play over the last 10 days or so. Really paying off tonight.
Puck scooped up by Del Sotto. Del Sotto's got it along the wing. Big time save with the blocker. Oh, look at this after the whistle here. Getting nasty.
Yeah, he's stirring the pot here. You get your glove into someone's face, you're trying to push them way back. Reader's ready to go. Apparently, the other guy doesn't want anything to do with him.
Oh, going wide. Thornton's taken down to the ice. We got a penalty coming up. Marlowe's called for tripping. He's off to the box.
It's a tough penalty to take. You're trying to do the right thing. Unfortunately, you pull his feet out, you got to go to the penalty box.
And manages to clear the zone. Maintains possession. And now he moves it quickly. Look at this. He's calling him out here, Ray.
Yeah, he wants to go. He's not very happy. Hutton's turning this challenge down. That's not part of his game.
Scores! And the deadlock is broken!
Well, what a crushing goal to give up. But the other guys work hard for it. They press the play, and now they've got the lead.
Here in the back half of this period, Peoria's got the momentum with a one-goal lead. They'd love to add to that. Come against the wall into the open ice. Stopped by the goaltender. Slides it over with pace to Smith-Pelly. Peoria's got a chance to work the transition game now, shorthanded. Trying to gain separation. Big time stop on the break. And a face wash with the glove after the whistle here.
Yeah, that's always going to provoke something, man. Somebody get a glove in my face. You got to push it back. You can't have them doing that to you. Lindbergh's done everything here except pull the other guy's gloves off.
With the stop.
I think through traffic like that, you're just hoping the thing hits you.
Being stopped by the keeper. Peoria's got the lead here late in this first period. Lindbergh's won the faceoff. Yaskins gaining momentum. Carries it across the line. Maroon's tripped up and the official's hand is in the air, signaling penalty. Let's see what the official says here. Pretty cut and dry trip on that play.
Coaches will tell you, be careful with your stick, but you're trying to get the puck. I don't think a lot of times they do it intentionally.
Here's a chance. Stopped by the goaltender. The Aces have controlled this game here in the first period. More shots, more goals. And as the puck is dropped, they win the draw here inside the defensive zone. And he gets the puck right back. Takes the feed at center and moves up ahead. And look at this, a 3-on-1. Makes a save, cool and calm under pressure. Great reflexes, another save. Trying to come up with a huge defensive play to get this puck out of his own end. Peoria's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Tripped up on the play, delayed penalty coming up. There's the stoppage of play. Let's see what the officials say. And he's heading to the box for two for tripping on this one.
This is such a bad penalty to take because you put yourself in a bad spot. The player falls down, now you're cooked. You go to the box.
Well, he's got 2 minutes to think about it now.
43 seconds.
Well, there's the horn, concluding the first 20 minutes. Time to get a clean sheet of ice. Well, batten down the hatches. If the first period was any indication, we are in for a shootout tonight. It's 3-1 after 20.
Please don't throw any objects on or towards the playing surface at any time during the game. The throwing of any object is grounds for immediate removal from this building.
clean sheet of ice. Period two is set to go. Peoria's penalty killers have their work cut out for them here, but a nice start to the period as they win the draw. And that goes off a player in front. Grabs the puck and moves on out here with this man advantage. The Aces gain possession along the wall with the stop. Quick pass to Thornton. Now he takes it over the line. Here's a chance. He scores! Putting the special in special teams tonight.
The extra work they've done, the way that they've moved some people around, has helped them cash in more. On the power play.
Face off here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Kaikovsky. And he heads outside the comfort zone now to go play the puck at his own end. Along the wing up the neutral zone. Flips it on net. Scores! And he puts his team in front.
James, this game looked really comfortable as a tie game. Now they're ahead. They've got to continue to push. They tell you it doesn't have to hit the back of the net. It's just got to get over the goal line for it to count. That one does. The goalie had a big chunk of it. Just not enough.
Peoria's been the more aggressive team offensively, and they continue to lead here in the second. Shot from the wall. And he says no! Whistle blown as the puck is directed out into the crowd and a souvenir for some lucky fan tonight. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro with you here in the early going of this period. Peoria's got a one-goal lead. Spies has been tripped up, and we got a penalty coming up here. Hutton swooping in on the attack. Here's a short pass to Aberg. Pokes it away in his own end. Here's the official call. Aberg's getting two for tripping.
Reaching for the puck, trying to be in position. You're just a little bit away, and then you get nabbed for tripping.
Yeah, it's always tough to use the I got stuck excuse, right?
It never works.
As we're about to drop the puck, the power play unit back out onto the ice for another opportunity.
This is a pretty simplistic power play. They like to get the puck, shoot it, crash the net, get it back, and shoot it again. What a great time to have a man advantage as they trail by one.
Here's a chance on the doorstep, and that goes off course wide.
Just misses the net, but really the scoring chance is not dangerous if you can't get the puck at the goaltender. Oh, that's going to be a penalty. They're going to have to call that.
Penalty coming up here as the play is stopped. Phaneuf's getting called for 2 minutes here by the officials.
They're going to be down a man here. Once he gets his stick into the player's feet, it's almost inevitable a tripping penalty will result.
Tough to argue that call. Manages to hang on. Auberg's hauled down. Penalty on the way. Let's see what the official makes for the final decision. Officials calling tripping here on this one.
This was the penalty I think when I took, I was most angry at myself because you're not trying to do it. And then all of a sudden you see the guy go down and you're just like, oh man, here I go.
And there's the result. Sent into the far corner. Takes the feed from the goaltender. He's got a step. What a stop by the goaltender.
Yeah, he was able to gauge his speed against the skaters. He moved back nicely with him to make the stop.
Grabbed along the board by Hutton. Tension's rising.
Didn't take much to get this heated up. Hutton's not so sure about the weight class here. He says no thanks.
Stays with it for the save.
He was all over this deep. A nice move, but the goaltender is right on it.
Poked away from danger. Tries to get this man advantage going from their own end now. Picked up along the boards by Smith-Pelly. Settles things down and gets control of it once again. An attempt to clear the puck from deep inside his own end. And a big kill keeps the one-goal lead intact. We're back to even strength. Player goes down to the ice. There's the referee's hand in the air. Looks like we got a tripping penalty on the way. Back on a stick now. Here comes the official's call. Smith Pelly's going to the box for tripping.
He's fishing around trying to get to the puck. Unfortunately for him, he sweeps out his feet.
Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Gets it out of his own end. Trying to clear the zone and stirring the pot here after the whistle.
Yeah, a little friction and all of a sudden guys are getting heated. Bruce is looking around for somebody to fight. He's going to have to go and fill the dance card somewhere else.
Bruce is getting two for an unsportsmanlike.
When the ref slaps this tee on you, it jolts you because you don't think you're in that spot. Once it's called, it's kind of embarrassing.
And a long skate back to the bench when it's over. Here we go. A lengthy 5-on-3 power play looms.
Too many times on a long 5-on-3, the power play becomes static. Get it to the middle at the very least. Shoot it and make the penalty killers react.
And now it's grabbed by Hutton. And now he moves it to Maroon. Tape to tape. All alone! Big stop!
Oh, outstanding stop. He reads in nicely on the shooter who tried to fake him out of position. No dice.
More than half the frame has been played here. It's a one-goal game at this point. 4-3 is the score. And the goaltender grabs that one for a whistle to try to slow things down here. Peoria's lead here in the second period, a direct result of being the more aggressive team offensively. Shot comes up with a stop. Peoria's done a nice job of generating pucks on net, and as a result, they lead here in the second. And momentum on their side as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Lot of John back and forth here.
Is there ever? I mean, the guys look like they're pretty agitated. Aberg's not interested in dropping the mitts and going at it.
They'll go back to work on their special teams.
Nothing more than average on this power play tonight, James. They get another one here. It would be nice for them to have some real positive minutes on the power play.
He scores! A shorthanded marker!
I don't think the penalty killers ever really looked for a shorty, but if the opportunity's there, now they're more aggressive than they've ever been. Yeah, good luck there, Tender. That thing's in and out so fast, he doesn't even move.
Peoria's now gone up by a pair in the second.
So they've got a two-goal lead. Some people say it's the worst lead in hockey. Well, guess what? I'll take the worst lead as opposed to trailing by two.
Yeah, you know what's better than down by two? Being up by two, right?
Of course it
is. Simple. Pokes it away to keep the pressure on. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. And there's the whistle, yet another penalty set to be handed out here. Caught him just as he was picking up speed, and he's going to pay for it with the trip.
Oh, you're spinning with him, you're trying to get your stick into the puck lane, and you end up tripping him up.
Stopped by the goaltender. The Aces have it from their own end. We got a delayed call coming up here as the referee raises his hand. Puck lands back onto his stick. And there's the whistle. Let's get the call from the official here. Daly's going off to the box for 2 minutes.
He's got to keep his feet moving so he doesn't get called for interference.
Big opportunity here for them. They'll have plenty of time to work this 5-on-3.
And it's quite some time on the 5-on-3. What a big advantage for them. They have to take advantage of this opportunity. You can't let a two-man advantage slip away.
And he slides it quickly to Yaskin. It's a 2-on-1. Sends it across. There's another stop.
He's right on it. Two consecutive saves. Tough ones at that.
Takes the puck as the clock ticks down on the penalty kill. Unleashes a cannon. And he stands tall in goal. Moves it to Smith Pelly. Great poke check on the reach. There's the whistle. Offside is the call. Peoria's generated a lot of quality scoring chances, which is why they lead here late in the second. Puck is dropped and play resumes. Hammers the shot. He scores! Another shorthanded marker. You don't see that often.
No, they're not a very passive group killing penalties, are they? That's a couple of times where they've just taken advantage of a mistake and raced up the ice.
Peoria's offensive volcano continues to erupt here in the second period.
They look like a juggernaut. They're running into this second intermission with a large lead.
Petrovic's got the puck in his own zone. Here's a race for the loose puck. Slides away from his crease now to play the puck.
Power play expires, and they've got to be left shaking their heads as they fail to convert and serve up a shorthanded goal.
Well, that doesn't go according to plan. The power play's done, and they've given up a shorty. Those are always deflating.
Second period nearly into its final minute here. Comes up with the stop. Oh, the poke check. What a read by the goaltender. And there's the whistle. Icing is the call, which I gotta say is like almost the equivalent of a tie. Who likes icing?
It might be the most boring play in hockey, but if you get an offensive zone faceoff.
Hey, there's a victory. Here he is in front, and that caroms right off the mask. Welcome back, everyone. He's Ray. I'm James. Third period action ready to go. It's been a total mismatch here as we get underway for the third. Let's see if anything changes. Ray, with two periods in the books, what are your thoughts on the game to this point?
Peoria's players have to be feeling a little frustrated. They've had much of the time of possession, but they're still chasing the game.
Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. And he uses his reach to disrupt the play. Hutton's moving the puck through his own zone. Puck grabbed by Aberg. Moves it around along the half wall. Here's a shot, and that one's turned away. Peoria's been a dominant force offensively. Plenty of quality scoring opportunities, and they lead it big time early in the third. The frozen biscuits dropped, and we are back underway here. And makes the save. With some momentum driving towards the net. Denies him again.
Nice work in there after the first stop. He's got to find the puck to save the second.
Slides it across, and he makes the save. And that slides right out to center ice. Erickson's taking it from his own end. Slides it up ahead from the right wing. Makes the save on the slapper. Moves the puck up to Yaskin. Yaskin's got it across the line. Great read to break up the play.
The Aces have been the better team all night long, and their positioning has been exceptional. They keep taking the puck away.
Peoria's laying a pounding on the opposition tonight, generating numerous scoring chances and converting on what feels like almost all of them. Back underway, and they take possession here inside the offensive zone. The Aces have a hold of it in the defensive zone. Let's it fly, and that one's stopped. Trying to get the puck out of the zone. And a burst of speed. They're going to wave off icing here, Ray.
Really good effort to go all the way down to get to the puck.
Denied by the goaltender.
He's got to work hard to find the puck through all the bodies right in front of him.
Peoria's offense has been the story tonight, leading big time here in this third period. Taken by Hutton. Kind of lost control for a second there, but regains possession. Tempers flaring.
Yeah, a little bump together, a little friction. Looks like the guys want to get it going. Hutton's turning this challenge down. That's not part of his game.
Puck picked up by Englund. Takes it across the blue line. Shuts him down. And off the save, that one goes into the crowd for a souvenir. The Aces continue to lead big here in this third period. Lindbergh's won the faceoff deep inside the offensive zone. Moves the puck across to Yaskin. And a nice poke check inside the neutral zone. Rips it along the wall. What a save! He'll probably feel that one tomorrow. Peoria showing no signs of slowing down here in this third period, up big time. Thornton's won it off the faceoff. Puck scooped up by Aberg. And he slides it quickly to Hutton. Hutton's got it in the offensive zone. Takes a shot, and that's blocked. The Aces scoop it up along the boards. Here they come on the attack. Poked away by the goaltender. And now it's grabbed by Hutton. And pokes the puck loose inside the offensive end. Peoria's got the puck. Puts it in deep. The Aces get a hold of the puck along the boards. And manages to clear the zone. And as we hit the final minute of this one, that has been a one-sided affair. Peoria's up big time here in the late stages of this third period. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Oh, he gets a blocker on it. What a reaction. Moves it quickly over to Del Sotto. Big save by the goaltender once again.
Oh, he followed the puck really well there. A couple of good stops.
The Aces have pummeled their opponents tonight. They have been the busier team offensively and have converted numerous times here in this third period. And makes the save. And he's tripped up on the play. Referee's hand goes up here. Here comes the call from the official. And he's off to the box for two for tripping.
Not much of an argument there. A stick between the player's feet.
Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Gets it out of his own end. Grabs control of it at the point. Denies him with the save. Peoria's got a hold of it along the wall. The Aces have it in the offensive zone. Fanouf's carrying it ahead. Gets the puck back onto a stick. Good defensive effort to poke it away. A chance to get it out. Cross the blue line and they'll get that much needed change, Ray.
Yeah, they've got to get guys off the ice. They look tired. Now you can get a fresh group on the ice.
And that sails over the net.
Missed by a large margin.
Scores! A shorthanded goal!
Well, you're just trying to kill the penalty off. This is terrific work as they take advantage of a little bit of a bobble and they go ahead and capitalize shorthanded.
And play resumes as the puck is dropped. And it is all over with this one. 1-0, it's not do or die, but how important is that win?
Well, you feel better about yourself. You feel like you've got the leg up, which you do. And now you put so much pressure on your opponents for game two.
In short, you simply have to love playoff hockey. For Ray Ferraro, my name is James Cebulski. Thanks so much for joining us this Cebulski, along with Ray Ferraro. We are so looking forward to the action in this one tonight. Ray, it's an honor to be able to call a Stanley Cup playoff tilt. The intensity here you feel just moments away from puck drop.
The guys are almost vibrating down here, James. They've been so excited to get this final series started. I can't imagine how much fun it would be to play in this.
A sight every hockey fan can appreciate. It's a clean sheet of ice, and we are about to get underway. The cup is on the line. Game one. Let's go. Oh, absolutely owns the crease tonight. Nice start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. Quick feed to Daly. And it's a quick pass to Kajkowski. Textbook stop by Ward. Glove to the face like a modern-day version of challenging to a duel.
Yeah, if you get that done to you, you've got to fight back. You can't have that happen. Gardner's not so sure about the weight class here. He says no thanks.
Knoxville's looking to break out of their own end. Peoria's gained possession along the boards. Ward's on top of that for the whistle.
Pretty quickly on top of it to kill the play.
Offense his own face-off, and he wins the draw. Denied by the goaltender.
He's working hard to find this puck. There's all kinds of traffic in front of him, and he gets to it before the puck gets to him.
Big save by the goaltender. DeSingles picking up steam. Move to the middle.
This has been a heck of a shift for them. They've got them hemmed into the offensive zone. Now they can carry the puck around as the defenders are just going to play a tight box. They look exhausted.
Scores!
Maybe.
Wait a second here.
Yeah, I think this is a high stick. This was disallowed right away, and now they'll get another look to confirm.
We haven't even hit the midway mark of the period. We got a 1-0 game to this point.
By number seven, Pontus Avalanche.
Tees it up from the back end. Comes up with a stop. Whistle blown as that's redirected into the crowd. Peoria still got time here in this first period to increase this lead. Agostino's won the draw. And he comes up with a big time save on that. Oh, and another big stop. Well, here you go. The taunting has begun here.
Yeah, he's trying to stir the pot for sure. He gets his glove in his face. Nobody likes that. Cronwall's not interested in dropping the mitts and going at it.
Here's a shot. The Admirals get a hold of the puck in their own end. Quick pass to Aberg. Aberg's got it into offensive territory. Lets it go. Gets in front of it and sends it off course. Here's a short pass to Broussard. Look at the wheels as icing is waved off.
He anticipated that loose puck he got to the hash marks first, wins the race, and negates the icing.
Nice poke check. The Aces look to start the transition game. Cronwall stick handling in his own zone. Moves it to Aberg with possession along the wall. Referee's hand shoots high in the air. Looks like we got a tripping penalty coming up. And he sprints to the bench to get the extra attacker out on the ice. Let's see what the officials say. Tripping is the call, and it's pretty cut and dry, it seems, Ray.
Well, it's like you're in position, then you're not. You reach out, you trip them up, and there's no way to get out of it now. Oh, there's going to be a penalty on this play here, James.
Play is blown dead. We've got a penalty on the way. We got a minor penalty coming up here on this
one. Sure, James. I mean, this call was going to be made. You could see the play develop, and now they're going to have to serve 2 minutes.
Looking to break out here on the power play. Moves it quickly over to Thornton. Oh, boy. Here comes a 3-on-1. Makes the save. Peoria's got a hold of it against the wall. And he regains control of the puck. Dumps it in. He'll keep it alive and moves it ahead. Puck grabbed by Thornton. Pokes the puck away. Moves the puck along the half wall. Penalty coming up as the whistle stops the play. Tripping is the call. Did he sell or is that the right one in your mind?
I think it's the right one. He looks like he's picking up speed and the stick gets into his feet.
And manages to clear the zone.
14 minutes, 19 seconds.
Trying to get something going here with this man advantage as they start from their own end. Gets the puck in deep. The Aces have it against the wall. Here's a chance to clear the puck from his own end. And manages to clear the zone. Gardner's moving it ahead. Here they come, three of them. Puts it on net. Nowhere for that shot to go through. Gets it out of his own end. Here's an offensive chance. And the puck leaves the zone. Nice play shorthanded as they get control of the puck. And manages to clear the zone. Here's a rocket of a shot. What a stop. Now a quick pass to Del Zotto. And another stop. Here in the late going of the frame, 1-0 the score. Play resumes as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Big time stop there. And now it's over to Kaikowski. Less than a minute to go here in the opening frame. Deep inside the defensive end, still trying to clear. And player hauled down to the ice. Looks like we got a tripping penalty coming up here. Let's see the call here. Kajowski's been nabbed for tripping.
Like every player in the history of the game, he doesn't like the call, but he's going to have to go serve his minor penalty.
Second period set to get underway. Peoria's shorthanded unit gets off to a good start. They win the draw and take early possession. Taken by Brassard. Tries to get it over to DeSingle. Tosses it to Brassard. Along the half wall with the puck. And a poke check knocks the puck away. And a delayed penalty coming up as he got tripped up. Time for the officials to hand out the judgment. Tripped him up, and he's off to the box for it, Ray.
Reaching out for the puck to get your stick into his feet. This is the consequence.
Here inside the defensive zone, they get the puck. Gets it out of his own end. Sends it in on the attack. Brassard's lugging the puck. Receives the pass. Great pressure, forcing the turnover. And that banks off a stick. And he comes up with it. And now he moves it quickly to Lovejoy. A howitzer. That goes wide. Ward's going to hang on to that one for a whistle.
Quickly on top of that, James. He needed a cover there.
Peoria's been the more aggressive team offensively, and they continue to lead here in the second. Marlowe's won the draw here in the offensive zone. And there's the save. Still early on in this frame, James and Ray with you. So glad you could join us. 1-0 is where we sit at this point. Quick feed to Phaneuf. Handles the puck. Takes the shot. He scores! Even underman, they deliver.
Yeah, it's a sloppy play by the power play. But shorthanded, they get aggressive, they get up the ice, and are able to score while down a man.
More time off the clock as they grab the puck. That's probably not what they were planning on the power play. They serve up a shorthanded goal with the special teams unit, but now both teams back to even strength.
Oh, they're not going to think too much about that. You want to at least generate a little momentum. Oh, that's going to be a penalty. They're going to have to call that.
We got a penalty coming up here as the officials blow the play dead. Maroon's getting called for tripping.
Reaching out for the puck. I guess it's a little bit of a bad play. You've got to realize the guy's getting away. Let him go before you take the penalty.
The official's making him pay for it. Well, as both teams dig in for the faceoff here, just moments away, it's our first opportunity to look at the power play unit here. Special teams coming up huge on that goal.
They take advantage of having the extra man by moving the puck quickly. That's a beautiful goal.
Stick all night, and when they haven't, it's generally been in the back of the net.
They've taken the opportunities and they've capitalized. I mean, they've had the puck a lot, James, but they've not missed much.
Gets that puck back on a stick. Fires it into the offensive zone. And look at that sip down the ice to wave off icing.
You've got to get past the hash marks to get it waved off. He does a good job.
Save made by the goalie.
Good technique as the puck is over to the corner out of the way.
Quick pass to Kajkowski. Picked up along the wall by Maroon. They've got numbers. Makes the save. Peoria's offense came to play in a big way, and they lead big time here in the second. And momentum on their side as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Another stop by the goaltender.
Stop one, stop two. The goal
scores! Wow, this is unbelievable.
Four straight goals. They dominated this play.
Peoria's center makes his way back to center ice here for the faceoff. What a performance by these guys tonight.
They've been terrific, dominated the game at both ends of the ice. The pace of the game is what they want, and they're comfortably in front.
Peoria's had the better scoring opportunities and lots of them, which is why they lead in a big way here in the second. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Big time save on a big time shot. Peoria's dominated right from the start, their offense clicking on all cylinders, and they lead here in the second. Back underway, and they take possession here inside the offensive zone. Pass to Cronwall. Great defensive play to break it up.
Peoria's dominance tonight can be attributed to the way that they played positionally. They've smothered the game, and they are way out in front.
Reads it perfectly in the defensive end. Thornton's been brought down, and we're going to get a penalty here. Here comes the call. Just an old-school tripping call here on this one, right?
Sometimes I think you just get burned here, a little bit of a bad break. You're fishing around for the puck, and your stick gets into the other guy's feet.
Grabs the puck here in their own end. Moves the puck inside the offensive zone. The Aces gain control of the puck against the wall. Offside is the call, and we'll have a face-off just outside the offensive zone. Peoria's offense came to play in a big way, and they lead big time here in the second. Puck is dropped, and we are back underway. Dumps it in. Grabs the puck in the corner. Deflected away. Nice defensive use of the stick there. Dumps it into the O-zone. Take it along the wall. Wow! Another shorthanded marker.
Well, they're not laying back at all. They want to kill the penalty, sure, but they've seen something they can take advantage of.
Peoria's had the better scoring opportunities and lots of them, which is why they lead in a big way here in the second. Knoxville's got possession here in the neutral zone. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Just wide. Peoria's got possession while undermanned and manages to clear the zone. Well, the man advantage unit might welcome being back at even strength after giving up a shorthanded goal on that power play. And he's taken down the official's arm, signaling for a penalty. And they score! The Admirals needed that one as they get back to center ice.
They need a lot more than that. It's really been a poor performance by them so far.
Bruce has won the draw here in the neutral zone. Knoxville's got it in the neutral zone. Broussard's going to play it against the half wall. Centering pass, snaps it onto the net, and the stick gets a piece of it. Passes over to Aberg, and he gains the zone here. Makes the save and putting out the fire in front. And off the save, that one's redirected out of play. The Aces have to be feeling good about themselves here in the late stages of this second period as they continue to lead big. Puck picked up by Daly, and the traffic neutralizes that threat. Taken down, the officials caught it. And let's see what the call is. He's going off for tripping, and doesn't everybody feel like they're innocent on a trip?
You feel like you're innocent on most every penalty, but this one always feels like, God, did you really have to call it?
Knoxville's got the puck along the wall. Here's a short pass to Thornton. Scooped up along the wall by Yaskin. Here's a clearing attempt from their own end. And that one's blocked. They'll keep it on the attack. There's the whistle stopping play. Penalty coming up here. And he's going to the box for two. Delay a game is the call here, Ray.
Some people don't like it. I do like this penalty. The glass is 10 feet high. You're a pro player. You should be able to shoot it off the window.
More embarrassing penalty than this? Is there one?
No, not like this.
Quick snap! Stick save! And we are just moments away from the start of the third period. Here we go, third period set to get underway. Simply too much to not enough at this point. 40 minutes into this one here, Razor, how do you see things?
Peoria is able to see the finish line now. Here into the third period with a comfortable lead. Just don't start giving away chances.
Back underway as he wins the try inside the offensive zone. The Admirals gain possession along the wall. Pokes the puck away. Sent in deep, and they'll go off for a change. Shot! Grabs it with the glove.
He's on it. Good puck, still pushing and shoving. The whistle doesn't bring this play to a halt at all. Gardner's turning this challenge down. That's not part of his game.
Peoria's offense has been a thing to watch tonight as they lead it big time here early in the third. Takes the feed. Takes the puck at the point. One last rush here on this power play. And the officials are calling a delayed penalty here. Looks like a trip. And the puck stopper tags his man to get the extra attacker on the ice. Let's it fly! And that shot dies in traffic. And the officials will pass the sentence here, tripping the call on the play.
I don't necessarily think he's trying to trip him here, James, but he gets a stick into his feet. Down he goes.
Gets it out of his own end. Stopped by the goaltender.
A defenseman loves this. The puck doesn't stay in front of the net. It's now in the corner. He doesn't have to worry about fighting another guy for position.
It's a 3-on-1. Breakaway misses the net.
Yeah, he's trying to be too perfect here. He's looking to place this puck into one small area, but he misses the net.
Grabbed along the board by Gardner. The Aces, he scores! A friendly ping on that one.
Yeah, great shot. He's just trying to get it past the goaltender here. It hits the pipe and goes into the net.
Peoria's on total cruise control early in this third period. Puck scooped up by Daly. Knoxville's ready to go on the attack. They'll want to clear the zone here while they're trying to kill off this penalty. Both teams back to even strength, and after giving up, hits in! He scores!
Hard to get him, but quicker than that. A pair of goals in 40 seconds.
This is where you want run time here in hockey, right?
This game can't end quick enough. They're getting pounded.
Peoria's having a lot of fun out there tonight, but Ray, I can imagine it's a different story on the other side of the bench.
Yeah, half the guys out here are having fun. The other half, this game can't end quick enough.
He's got a step! Oh!
I thought this was in. Really good deke. He throws the goalie, but the reaction makes the save.
The Aces have shown no signs of slowing down here in this third period. Up big. And as the puck is dropped, they win the draw here inside the defensive zone. And the linesman calls icing on the play.
Hey, usually the whistle is going to stop the play. I guess not tonight. Maroon's ready to go. Apparently, the other guy doesn't want anything to do with him.
Peoria's laying a pounding on the opposition tonight, generating numerous scoring chances and converting on what feels like almost all of them.
Oh, he's trying to box him out. This is getting a little testy.
And a challenge being thrown down here, and the challenge is accepted. Absolutely rocked down to the ice there.
That was a heavy blow, and that is the end of this bout.
And here comes referee Gilles Levesque to clean things up. The Aces offense has been the story tonight as they continue to lead big time in the third. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Officials blow the whistle. We've got icing on the call.
Nothing too smooth about that play.
Peoria's offense has been the story tonight, leading big time here in this third period. Lindbergh's won it in their own end.
moves the puck into the attacking area. Swing and a miss with the stop. Tries to get it to Thornton. Over the line they come. Great defensive play to come up with the puck.
The Aces have done an amazing job positionally tonight. There's nowhere for the opponents to go.
Moves it to Marlow. And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. Glove save! All quick reflexes on the play. Knoxville's looking to break out. Nice stick work to knock the puck loose. The Admirals have it from their own end. Well, the officials have tried to keep things in line, and yet another penalty call here. Lovejoy's called for tripping. He's off to the box.
I always found this a frustrating penalty to take. There's really no aggression to it. You're trying to steal the puck, but you end up flipping the guy down.
12 minutes, 34 seconds.
And a tenacious effort pays off as he comes up with it. And it's freed up over to his teammate with a nice kick pass. Nice poke check inside the attacking zone. Puck lands right back onto the blade. Stays with it. Here's the pass. Into the corner. Hammers it. Oh, what a stop. The Aces get a hold of the puck undermanned. Takes the puck as the clock ticks down on the penalty kill. And manages to clear the zone. Hangs onto the puck. Lovejoy's out of the box and both sides are back to even strength.
Well, they're not going to do a much better job than that last penalty kill. All night, they've been really efficient killing penalties.
Pushes it across to Lovejoy. Feeds the puck over to Kajkowski. And skilled use of the stick to poke the puck away. And now he angles it across to Aberg. Tripped up on the play, delayed penalty coming up. Here's the official call. And he's heading to the box for two for tripping on this one.
This is such a bad penalty to take because you put yourself in a bad spot. A player falls down, now you're cooked. You go to the box.
Well, he's got 2 minutes to think about it now. Gets it out of his own end. And now it's grabbed by Gardner. And a stick in the lane ends that threat. To singles, got it on the offensive end. There's an offside stopping the clock late in this one. Peoria's put in one of their most complete efforts that we have seen in quite some time, up big time late in this third. Whiffs on that. Knoxville's gained possession along the boards with the stop. Daly's got it in the defensive end. Here's a chance to get it out. And he moves the puck across the blue line out of the defensive zone. From their own end, trying to kickstart this power play. Puck grabbed by Smith-Pelly. This one-sided affair finally nearing the end. Time running out with this man advantage. Here we go. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Comes up with the stop. Here's a chance to clear the defensive zone. And they get it out of the zone. And where are they headed to, Ray?
Time for a change. Everyone needs a little break here. They look a little tired. They get it out of the zone. And they can get some fresh troops on the ice.
Stopped by the goaltender.
That's a good save. He had to struggle to find the puck. It's a forest of bodies in front of him.
The Aces are in the home stretch of this one, leading big time in the third. And the lane's clogged up, blocking that. Picked up along the boards by Marlow. And the long-range shot goes off target. Turns it aside. Peoria's offense has not been a problem tonight. They put a lot of shots on net and lead it big time late in this third period. Nice start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. Grabs the puck and looks to make something happen. And that's broken up with a stick in front. And he slides it quickly to Lovejoy. Picks up the puck in his own end. There's the final horn, and that'll do it here this evening. Reyes, the proverbial drawing of first blood as they take the 1-0 series lead.
A well-played game for them. Now they've got a leg up. You try to, game by game, chip away at your opponents.
Turn down your MeTV and turn up for your community.
Be individual, I'll always be a human being, we'll always be community.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to EA Sports. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. The puck is set to be dropped here. The championship on the line for this one. Are you nervous or more excited as a player?
I think you're more excited, but the real challenge is don't look at what might be sitting there at the end of the game. Play the game moment to moment.
Just moments away from puck drop, both teams seem ready to go. This is what you play for. Moments like this, you can feel the energy in this building, and we are underway. Almost lost the puck, but hangs on here as play continues. Answers it with an even better save. Thornton's won a big draw on their own end. Peoria's got the puck along the boards. Gets the tip. Great save with a stick. Blast from the point. Again, the denial by the goaltender.
Really good stop. After he made the first one, he's got to find the puck, and he's in position again.
Offense his own faceoff, and he wins the draw. And that's blocked away. Breaks up the pass in the defensive zone. Here's a blast. Scores. Well, that's one way to silence the crowd.
It is. You don't want to play from behind on the road, chase the game, and they've done a terrific job here early in the first period getting the game's first goal.
Puck is dropped and play resumes. Brings the puck into the offensive end now. Oh, well, that didn't take long.
Yeah, early in the game, looks like each team trying to get an upper hand.
And down he goes.
That's a clear winner right there.
The Aces have the shot advantage, and they also have the lead on the scoreboard. And play resumes as the puck is dropped. Hammers the shot, comes up with the stop. Takes the feed at the back end. And he gets his glove on the changing shot.
They're still shoving long after the whistle's gone here. Somebody wants to go. Bruce has done everything here except pull the other guy's gloves off.
Play resumes as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Denied him on that last chance. Blocked in front. Grabs the puck here inside the offensive end. Wide of the net.
I like the shot. He didn't miss it by much, though.
Moves it quickly over to DeSingle. On the attack along the boards. Right in front with the shot. He scores!
Now you got to keep clawing back. Trailing in the game, they get the equalizer.
More than half the period left to play. We are all tied up in this one. Here's a blast from the boards. Brilliant save. Read it perfectly.
Time of the goal. 7:43.
Agostino's won the faceoff deep inside the offensive zone. Here's a chance in front. Here's a blast. Whoa. He scores! They take the lead!
Well, it looked like this game was going to be even for the longest time because nobody seemed to have the upper hand.
Peoria's goal scorers have given them a one-goal lead here in the first period.
I've liked the way that they came out, started this game. Now that they have the one-goal lead, see if they can expand upon it.
And he slides it quickly to Daly. Carries it in.
9 minutes, 9 seconds.
And it's a quick pass to Maroon. And the traffic jam in front blocks the shot. Great defensive effort with the stick. The Aces scoop it up along the boards. And makes the routine save. Handles the pass from his goalie. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check. Hammers one. He scores! I believe a colleague of ours likes to call those back-to-back.
Yeah, the coaches want you to stay aggressive after you score. They do that, and they're able to put another one up on the board.
This neutral zone face-off set to go, and we are back underway.
12 minutes, 45 seconds.
Takes the pass. Now a quick pass to Spezza. And now he moves it quickly to Marlowe. Carries it across the line. Knoxville's looking to break out of their own end. Hutton's been tripped up, and we got a penalty coming up here. Let's get the official decision.
Pretty cut and dry trip on that play.
Coaches will tell you, be careful with your stick, but you're trying to get the puck. Yeah. I don't think a lot of times they do it intentionally.
The Admirals get their man advantage unit out there for the first time tonight.
The power play can be so frustrating. When you get an opportunity and it doesn't go well, you start to press pretty quickly into it. Now's the time to relax, readjust, and attack again.
Pokes it away to stay on the attack. Ahead of steam now towards the front. Comes up with the stop.
Yeah, he got out tight to him, James. There's nowhere for that puck to go.
Picked up along the wall by Brassard. Some pushing and shoving here, heating up.
Yeah, the few words lead to a little bit more, it looks like. Brassard's not interested in dropping the mitts and going at it. Oh, there's going to be a penalty on this play here, James.
Officials calling tripping here on this one.
This was the penalty I think when I took, I was most angry at myself, because you're not trying to do it, and then all of a sudden you see the guy go down and you're just like, oh man, here I go.
There's the result. The frozen biscuits dropped and we are back underway here. And manages to clear the zone. Moves around along the half wall. One of the biggest icons in hip-hop will join us coming up in period number two. The D-O-double-G, Snoop Dogg, joins us in moments. Here in the late going of the frame, 3-1 is where we're sitting. Fans being treated to a lot of offense thus far. Takes a shot, and that one's turned away. Knoxville's got control of it now from their own end. Peoria's got a hold of it along the wall. Standing tall with the save. In front, and a stoppage on the play as the goaltender covers things up. The Aces have been the better team so far in this first period. They've had multiple scoring opportunities, and as a result, have the lead. And makes the save. Nice feed from the goaltender. Trying to get back on the attack now. Peoria's got possession at center. Whacks it into the offensive zone. Taken along the wall by Smith-Pelly. Maintains possession. Good check. Frees the puck up. Finoff's out of the box.
Well, no goal on that power play. They were able to move the puck. Oh, that's going to be a penalty. They're going to have to call that.
Quick feed to Smith-Pelly. Penalty coming up here as the play is stopped. Daly's going to the box for tripping. Played with fire. He got burned, Ray.
He's digging around for the puck, and sometimes you just get caught. This time the player goes down, and he's got to go to the box.
Unloads it! Oh, comes up with a stop! Hey, Ray Ferraro is usually a treat enough, but coming up in the second period, we've got a very special guest coming your way. There are legends, and then there are, what, immortals. And this guy joins us in the broadcast booth at this time. Here he is, the one, the only, Snoop Dogg, man. It is a pleasure, sir.
Hey, man, look here, James. The pleasure's all mine. What a night. What a night for some good hockey, baby.
What a party we've got now. Hey, when the Kings went to the silver and black look in the late 80s, you're a kid at the time, but did that add a little more street cred to the hockey team locally?
It really did. It put them right in the hood, you know what I'm saying? Because now we could start to rock those Kings jerseys and King hats because it was all black and gray. And if you notice in those videos in the early 80s, all of the rappers had them on from the West Coast.
And he makes the save. Offside the call, and we'll have a face-off just outside the blue line. Lots of time left in this period. It's a two-goal lead we're looking at with the score 3-1. Face-off here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway. Denies him on the play. The Admirals can't convert to the power play. Both sides are back to even strength. Knoxville's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Takes it across the blue line. Right out front. Oh, and he missed the opportunity there.
Everybody likes to think of themselves as a little bit of a clutch performer. If you score at this time of the year, you are that.
The Aces continue to lead here in this second period, looking strong offensively. And momentum on their side as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Taken by Cronwall. And he gets the puck right back. Player goes down to the ice. There's the referee's hand in the air. Looks like we got a tripping penalty on the way. England's getting two for tripping.
As soon as the hands go up, when they start to plead with the ref, you know they're guilty.
Nice play shorthanded as they get control of the puck. Gets it out of his own end.
4 minutes, 37 seconds.
Scooped up along the wall by Hutton. And some fancy footwork to kick it over to his teammate. Moves it to Aberg.
If you were commissioner for a day, what would you do?
I would make all hockey games start off with some hip-hop music. I would have a great halftime performance. And the games would be more interactive as far as finding ways to put the people involved. Not put them on the ice, but just make it more about the people. Like, when I watch other sports, I feel like the fans are more involved. So finding ways to create ways to make it all about everybody.
Alone on the ice, here's one on one. No, not on this goalie. He's not right having that. Get that out of here, man.
And let's see what the definitive call is on the ice. Bruce is off to the box. 2 minutes for tripping.
Trying to get into position to get to the puck. He takes out the player's feet, and off to the box he'll go.
Big opportunity here for them. They'll have plenty of time to work this 5-on-3.
With such a long 5-on-3 power play in front of them, they can afford to be patient. Don't take the first shot. Take the best shot. 19 seconds.
Hanging tonight here with Snoop Dogg. So I'll ask you this. If you were commissioner for a day, what would you do?
First thing I do is put some hip-hop music in all venues. We start the game with the national anthem and the Canadian anthem, and then we go straight off to some hip-hop and get this thing popping so quick, so fast.
Sounds like a party.
Yes, sir. That's what it has to be.
Quick pass to Maroon. Maroon's got it along the wing. Denies him in front. Trying to clear the puck. And he's able to move the puck across the blue line and out of harm's way. Last call here on this man advantage.
Yeah, the power play's got to get the puck up the ice with a little bit of urgency.
One-on-one. And he slides it quickly to Broussard. And that just falls apart.
No way to recover from that. That's a good-looking play that leads to nothing.
Play blown dead. Penalty coming up here. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Caught him just as he was picking up speed, and he's going to pay for it with the trip.
Oh, you're spinning with him. You're trying to get your stick into the puck lane, and you end up tripping him up.
Denies him on the slapper.
Stars sell the game here, Snoop. Who are some of the guys that you cheered for?
Man, Marcel Dion back in the days. I used to love the way he got out on Lemieux. And, of course, 99. Gretzky, the great one.
Have you ever met Wayne?
Man, me and Wayne, I'm the greater one.
You're the greater
one. That's my nephew.
Hey, look, I know I'm no Chick Hearn, but do you want to still hang around, watch the rest of this period?
Look here, James, I got a little bit of time on my hand. Let's do it, baby. Let's enjoy this.
There he is. He's going to hang out with us.
Let's go.
The Admirals fail to capitalize on the man advantage. Both sides back to even strength.
Another good penalty kill for them, James. They've done the job start to finish when they've been shorthanded.
Strong defensive effort. Manages to hang on. They've got the defense outnumbered. Peoria's got a hold of it against the wall. Maroon swooping in on the attack. What a stop as he puts out the fire! Takes the pass from his goaltender. Referee's hand shoots high in the air. Looks like we got a tripping penalty coming up. Let's see what the officials say. He's going off for tripping, Ray.
Reaching in for the puck, and he gets his stick caught in their feet.
And as the puck is dropped, they win the draw here inside the defensive zone. And manages to clear the zone. Gardner's gaining momentum. Long reach breaks up the momentum. With possession along the wall. Puck picked up by Maroon. Moves the puck along the half wall. From the point, takes a shot, and that one's stopped. Moves with the puck at the corner. And a bad pass, and they'll be forced to start all over again outside the offensive end. Along the half wall with the puck. Yaskin's now out of the box, and we are back to even strength.
Well, the coach has got to be happy with their penalty killers. But they also... Oh, there's going to be a penalty on this play here, James.
Good defensive stop with the poke check. Play is blown dead. We've got a penalty on the way. Sin bin bound for tripping.
I always hated taking tripping penalties. It always felt like there was something I could have done better than that.
Grabbed along the board by Broussard. And player hauled down to the ice. Looks like we got a tripping penalty coming up here. There's the whistle. Let's get the official decision. Kajowski's been nabbed for tripping.
Trying to get to the puck. He reaches his stick right into the guy's feet. And down he goes.
Gets it out of his own end. Tries to get this man advantage going from their own end now.
takes it from the...
Him versus the goalie. Goalie versus him. Oh, back in the net. Give me mine. What a move, baby.
Were you expecting this when you got up here?
No way, no how.
The Aces have generated plenty of quality scoring chances and a big reason why they lead late in the second period.
By number eight, Joel Thornton.
Thornton's eyes are looking for three. He's got two in his back pocket. Dangerous player now.
Lindbergh's got it across the line. Turns him away. Knoxville's got the puck. Puck scooped up by Thornton. And there's the whistle. Yet another penalty set to be handed out here. Tripping is the call, and it's pretty cut and dry, it seems, Ray.
Well, it's like you're in position, then you're not. You reach out, you trip them up, and there's no way to get out of it now.
He is the D-O-double-G, the dog father himself, Snoop Dogg, and we thank him so much for his time here on NHL 20. Third period is coming up in moments. Lots of action at both ends of the ice so far through 40 minutes. We've got a 3-2 game. Moment of truth for one team. Here we go. Third period is underway. Well, we've got two periods under our belts to this point so far, Ray. How do you see things?
Knoxville's players have been a turnover machine tonight. Every time they have it, it seems like they force it into an area where they lose it. They lose the puck. They're losing the game.
And manages to clear the zone. Fires it on net. Answers the call with a big save. Retrieves the puck, trying to kickstart this power play. Oh, great little takeaway at center.
The Aces have done a good job with their sticks, intercepting passes, yet they haven't been able to stretch this game out.
Here's a chance to get it out of their own end, and they remain a goal behind all alone. Oh, what a stop.
Oh, goaltender looked so sure as he made that stop on the breakaway.
Still early on in this frame, James and Ray with you. So glad you could join us. 3-2 is where we sit in what has been a tightly contested affair. Denies him! He got all of it! And the goalie covers up for the whistle. Peoria's done a wonderful job putting a lot of pucks on net, and they lead it early in this third period. Back underway, and they take possession here inside the offensive zone. Ward's gonna...
Oh, he's trying to box him out. This is getting a little testy. Cronwall's...
And they're gonna drop the mitts here. There, and that'll pretty much do it.
Yeah, that's not going to go to the judges.
The Aces lead this one early in the third period. They have been the more aggressive team offensively with the lead in the shot department. Back underway as he wins the try inside the offensive zone. Off a stick. From one point man to another. Tremendous read and even greater sacrifice on the block. Lovejoy's got the puck in his own zone. Shot from the wall and a great save. Ward's on top of the puck and that'll stop the play.
Pretty conservative play here, James, as he covers it up to kill the play.
Inching closer to the midway mark of this period. It's a one-goal hockey game. 3-2 is where we sit. Hammers it on net, rings the iron. From the point, they take control of it. Scores! Peoria's attempt to put more pucks on net has paid off as they lead it in the third. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. The Admirals get a hold of the puck in the open ice.
Assisted by number six, Dion Fleming.
And a delayed penalty coming up as he got tripped up. Let's see the call here. Looks like tripping the call.
Sometimes they're lazy, sometimes they're just bad luck.
Another power play opportunity coming up here.
Hey, another power play for them. They've been successful tonight. I don't think they changed the script much here.
Denied by the goaltender. Picked up along the boards by Marlowe. Gardner's taken down to the ice. We got a penalty coming up. Rips it from the blue line. Makes a save. Cool and calm under pressure. Let's see what the official makes for the final decision. And he's off to the box for two for tripping.
Not much of an argument there. A stick between the player's feet.
Knoxville's ready to go on the attack. Quick shot. The lane was plugged up and that shot's blocked.
And the officials stop the play as the puck heads off the ice.
Peoria's got the edge in the shot department, a big reason why they lead here in this third period.
Here inside the defensive zone, they get the puck. Grabs the puck and moves on out here with this man advantage. Here's a short pass to Thornton. From the slot, wrist shot. He's looking for a dance partner.
Yeah, he looks like he wants somebody, anybody to engage with. Lovejoy's looking around for somebody to fight. He's going to have to go and fill the dance card somewhere else.
Lovejoy's getting two for an unsportsmanlike.
Like every player in the history of the game, he doesn't like the call, but he's going to have to go serve his minor penalties.
And the puck stopper jumps on top of it to get a stoppage in play. The Aces have looked good tonight, especially offensively here in this third period. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Pokes it away to keep the pressure on. And we've got a two-on-one. Stones him in front. And that goes off a player. Peoria's grabbed a hold of the puck. Peoria's got a chance to work the transition game now shorthanded. And he's taken down the official's arm, signaling for a penalty. And the goaltender gets to the bench for the extra attacker and makes the save. Here comes the call. Just an old-school tripping call here on this one, Ray.
Sometimes I think you just get burned here, a little bit of a bad break. You're fishing around for the puck, and your stick gets into the other guy's feet.
More time off the clock as they grab the puck. Denied by the goaltender. Knoxville's got the puck in their own end. Now he takes it over the line. Look out. Here's a 2-on-0.
For no threat. Scores! Wow, this is a great reaction, James. He doesn't have much time to finish it off. Makes a perfect shot.
The Admirals are setting this up for an interesting finish here, Ray.
A lot more interesting than it was a couple of minutes ago. Now just down one, James. They can do this.
Here's a shot. Stops him cold. Moves it to Gardner. And pokes the puck loose inside the offensive end. Here they come on the attack. And that's broken up. Peoria's got the puck now. Here's an opportunity to clear the zone. Scoops up the puck behind the net. Keeps hold of the puck. To his teammate. Slides the puck near the front of the net. Great reflexes. Another save.
Really sharp. Never loses sight of the puck to make the second save.
Kunoff's penalty has expired.
Oh, they're going to rue that one. A chance to even the score here. They didn't get it done. And we go back to even strength. Oh, that's going to be a penalty. They're going to have to call that.
Moves the puck. And someone's going off here as the ref's hand goes high in the air. Here comes the call. Ray, they're going to the box and a lot of time here for this, too.
Yeah, what often happens is you commit one penalty, then everybody loses their concentration, and before you know it, you've made another bad play, and now you got to kill off a couple.
It's essentially contagious for what they've done here, getting penalized. In front, the puck stopper gets on top, but we'll get a little stoppage in play here, Ray.
Yep, goalies are going to jump on it as quick as they can anytime around the front of the net.
Nice start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. And he gets in the lane to block that. Marlowe's carrying it ahead. Breakaway. Oh, and he's signaling penalty shot here on the play.
Tripped up on the breakaway. The ref makes the right call.
Denies him.
Well done. Good stop. The shooter's looking for a hole. There is none there. The goalie was all over it.
Peoria's been the better team offensively tonight. A lot of scoring chances, and they lead it late in this third period. Gets it out of his own end. Picked up along the wall by Smith-Pelly. Sends it quickly to Maroon. Smart defensive play here in the open ice. Agostino's moving the puck through his own zone. A chance to clear. And that's a big clear on that play.
Yeah, coaches are always telling us about details. There's one of them. Get the puck out late in a game.
Peoria's got the puck along the wall. And now it's grabbed by Phaneuf. He's got a step. Oh, what a save on the breakaway.
There are big moments in a close game, and that's one of them.
Less than a minute to go now here in regulation. Lets it fly. Blocker saved by the goalkeeper. Tries to get the puck to Yaskin.
Now you don't have to build a new hotel every time you have the puck. Just get the thing forward. Don't turn it over. Don't make a mistake that allows them to come back and push against your team.
trailing in this one. They have pulled the goalie and the extra attackers out. Sends the pass over. Comes up on the blocker save. There's another stop. And the officials are calling a delayed penalty here. It looks like a trip. Official blows the whistle. Let's see what the call is. Pretty cut and dry with a tripping call here.
Yeah, but James, every player argues the tripping call because you feel like your stick was in the right place and the other guy stepped on it. Never your fault.
And it looked like there was some late moment lobbying there and it didn't work.
It doesn't work.
No, none. Just seconds away now as they are set to hoist the Stanley Cup. It is all over. What every single one of these players played for, Stanley Cup champions ring.
When they get a close look at this trophy, they'll see all those names engraved on it. And then one day, their name is going to be on it very soon.
Congratulations to the champions. No shame in getting to the Stanley Cup, but can you take solace in winning a conference championship?
Yeah, yes, you can, but it's not going to be the same. Look at how happy the guys are that have won. They went all the way to the wall, and they found a way across the finish line. What an amazing achievement to win the Cup.
An opportunity for a tip of the cap, if you will, for both sides here, Ray.
Yeah, not easy to get through, though, James, because you look at somebody that's just beaten you in a hard-fought series, and you have to say, good game, even if you don't mean it.
There he is, the best player of the postseason. What a run, and there's your Conn Smythe winner.
You go up, you get congratulations, you get the trophy, but you really want to be back with your teammates as quick as you can.
He's coming to collect the Stanley Cup. I can't even imagine how hard his heart is beating right now.
It must be an amazing feeling. Every time I see them hoist the cup year after year, I feel a little pang of jealousy that I never got to do it. Look at this. What a great celebration.
Oh, I love this moment. And I'm always curious to see the pecking order, too, from the seniority or however it works, Ray. But you love seeing the guys getting through respective turns.
I can't believe that there's a list. It's just like everybody knows where you're supposed to go.
Is it a mental one or is it actually written out?
Well, I think you'd look at a 10-year guy and go, I'm not grabbing it before him.
Is this where you get jealous in these celebrations here?
No, I was jealous before when the cup came out. I am again now.